I spent 30 days drawing to improve my art. That's a lot of time. But there's a problem. I only got 10 days of experience drawing. So it feels like I'm drawing with a brick tied to my hand. But even worse than that, this is me writing my ABCs with my eyes closed. And this is me, eyes open, writing on the tablet for the first time. 30 days is a lot until you realize I gotta learn hands, feet, folds, faces, muscles, hair, eyes, shading, and then juggle them all at once. I just want to be able to draw cute women, man. Will I be able to draw the image I have in my head? Can I become an art god in only 30 days? The results might surprise you. Alright, the first thing I need to do is create a benchmark. Because after 30 days of mental warfare, I want something to look back on. But look at my benchmark. I kid you not, I was trying hard to draw this. Not gonna lie, I gave up on the hair, but really? It looks like I put him in the blender. Color can't even save this man. The difference between drawing on paper and a tablet was huge. So that's when I came up with the best idea ever. Let's break the art law and do the one thing every artist hates. Tracing over people's art. Now, let me explain before I get attacked. Tracing allows me to build up my muscle memory, so when I need to actually draw an extra long curve in one stroke, I might just be able to do it. Next, I started watching videos on how to get better at drawing characters. They said gesture drawing. I was pointed to this website, but what the f***? I ain't signed up for that shit, man. Why is naked on default? The owner of the website must be a comedian. I know the pros be drawing naked people, but you can count me out. Because number one, it ain't that deep. And number two, could you imagine if someone walked in? I have no lock on my door. I'm about to get hit with the, are you winning, son? Like, I can see the whole situation playing out right now. This was actually taken from a future timeline. I will draw women with swimsuits on, though. No guys, though. Not today, Lil Nas X. Strictly women. All right, so the goal here is to capture the energy of the pose and construct it. I already have a little bit of knowledge on human proportions. But there's a huge problem. What am I drawing right now? I can't even draw a straight line. So here's a plan. For a good hour, I'm about to just start tracing over random images in my folders. So maybe by the end of the video, I'll at least be able to control my pen enough to write my name. Yeah, so I've been doing this for 2 hours now. But not gonna lie, I can't control my pen for anything. I feel the reason why drawing on a tablet is hard needs to be explained. I'm drawing without looking at my hands right now. I have to look up at the screen. I'll get used to it though. Day two, all right, this is when things started to pick up. I did 10 figure drawings straight in a row, and all I gotta say is this art stuff is hard. I don't think I was able to completely sketch out one drawing with a timer set at 60 seconds. Also, I feel like my eyeballs are looking at some of the most cursed images on the internet right now. Like, guys, I am really not messing with these images. They're kind of cursed. After a while, I started to feel like gesture drawing was not it for me because I started copying what I saw instead of understanding what I saw. So I decided to start constructing my figures while trying not to make them look robotic. I mean, these joints are still looking like some robots, but look at the difference from here to here. Honestly, not that huge, but mentally I've changed. But I got a question. What is this? The stuff I'd be running across while looking at art. Don't look at his eyelids. They're not there. But guys, look at my scientific finds here. Every body part is a head length long. Oh my gosh, guys, no freaking way. People that I've been drawing for years are looking at me like, no shit. But for real, all this anatomy stuff got me tripping up. All right, I did some more 2-minute figure drawings, and I was already getting some better results. They're looking a bit more solid. But really, I'm just glad I remembered to turn off the nude option. All right, it's day three. Look who I found. It's LeBron after he gets dunked on by Michael Jordan. No way. Anyways, today I was back at that good stuff. You know, my favorite thing, tracing. It's just so calming. I mean, I am listening to Kanye West going crazy on the track right now, but it's still calming. All right, it's day four and I still need to work on a ton. The humans kept getting messed up. Like, I don't even think I need to point it out. It's just bad. Everything looks easy until you do it yourself. I need to drill that into my head because I keep falling for the same trap. Here I start drawing the pelvis as a shape that looks like underwear because the pelvis is terrifyingly hard to get right. I always end up placing it in the wrong place. I mean, just look at a pelvis though. Why does it look like that? It looks stupid. I can't even think of a reason for the pelvis to have two holes like that. Like, what are the holes for? What purpose does it serve in this situation? Anyways, basically, I thought it'd be a good idea if I constructed the figure over the person, then I would try it on the side so I could get a better understanding of what I was drawing. Then, when I went back to gesture drawing, they were looking a bit more structured. Jeez, look at my hair drawing skills. Beautiful. And also, I have a problem where I hold pens and mouses like a madman whenever I do anything. So holding my pen lighter is something I gotta work on, or else I'm gonna end up with some freaked up fingers. Like some face way fingers. But to be honest, I'm still happy with the progress. The plot points on my mannequin men are getting much better. Day five, and I started to learn how to digitally paint. In the beginning, they had us drawing an eye. First, we outlined the eye, then colored the eye, blurred some colors together, and then we added some final last touches. And I mean, I'm pretty happy with the way it turned out. It easily could have ended up burning your guys' eyes with its ugliness. But his eye looks a little bit more 3D, while mine looks flat. And also, I noticed it didn't look bad to me at first, but side by side, this is not a competition. At least we don't have to
draw the second eye.
But eventually I'll be able to, because this is a level I'm trying to hit.
It's beautiful.
All right, next I learned that white actually isn't white.
Well, let me explain.
All right, you see my cursor?
I'm grabbing the teeth color.
But if you look at the color palette,
her teeth aren't actually pure white.
No way.
Well, look what happens when I make it actually white.
Kind of creepy.
Same with the eye.
So basically, you probably shouldn't use pure white.
Here I learned how to shade a ball and a cube.
Two shapes that you can easily make very trippy.
But not too much to say here.
It's just some basic shading.
It's day six.
I was gonna paint a teapot of all the course and learn about colors.
But nah, we're gonna skip those lessons.
I'm already too smart with it.
Warm colors make you happy. Cool colors make you sad.
Nah, that's a horrible explanation, but
I already know color theory and I'm not trying to nerd out.
As long as your painting doesn't look like my channel page, then you should be fine.
Alright, so I was coloring this girl and she looks pretty cool, but
is this really what the people wanted?
No,
this is not what the people wanted.
Let me introduce you
to your favorite neighborhood goon,
Zoidora!
Now, this is what the people wanted.
Alright, so today I woke up at 8 and just started instantly drawing 10 minutes later.
Because it's been a whole week and I still don't got a feel for the pen.
I can't draw folds, faces, hands, feet,
freaking folds.
I wrote folds twice in the screen. This is how deep it is.
So for this morning, my focus was to get better lines. So to do that, I did some more tracing drills. I was trying to use my elbows and shoulders more than my wrist.
I already hold my pen tight enough.
No need to cripple my wrist.
Also, I've been spending a lot of time doing figure drawings,
but I still had the problem where I couldn't get my figures nice curves. So I just started going crazy,
drawing torsos at every and any angle.
Even in my dreams, I saw torsos.
And eventually I became one with the torso.
Not really though.
I still wasn't happy with the results. So I looked for different ways I could draw the pelvis and ribs. And I found this guy, Akihito, and I really enjoyed his video.
He was teaching without saying a single word, but I understood everything he was doing.
And look at the legs I drew.
George's looking pretty leggy.
Yeah, I said leggy legs.
But ew, look at this.
Hands.
Ugh. Not gonna be doing those.
Not dying today.
We'll tackle them later.
I was grinding though. Look at the legs. Look at the hips.
Still happy with today's progress. I was able to drop the time needed for me to draw a figure from 10 minutes to 5 minutes.
I'll take that anytime.
Alright, so I started the day by working on my pen control like the days before, drawing circles, flowers, tracing, but this time I was gonna do things correctly. I was making sure the whole time I was using my arm so I don't break my wrist off, and I even ended up doing some more figure drawing today. For this one, I decided to give her some hair, and yeah, I know it's the best hair you've ever seen, and if you look at her, it's pretty spot on when I match it up. Just needs a bit more work. By the way, if you're wondering why I'm always drawing women, it's pretty simple. Number one, they're curvier, so it's better practice. Number two, I'm not trying to look at guys in boxers, and yeah, that's basically all my excuses. All right, day 9, and yeah, the only thing I did today was a draw a pelvis
for like 5 hours straight.
Not even trolling.
I don't got a burnout point, so I just be grinding.
But I really think I learned a lot here.
All right, we finally hit double digits.
And guess what I did all day?
I drew torsos all day.
Or at least it felt like that. It was really 2 hours.
And then I did 2 hours figure drawing.
I tried to do some crazy poses this time because why not? They weren't that perfect, but it let me know that I definitely needed to make a lot more torsos because I don't understand them right now.
And I hate torsos. So much curviness. Like, can we just not?
Why can't we all just be like Tesla Bot?
Actually, I said that before I took another look at Tesla Bot, and he's actually pretty curvy.
Not sure how to feel about that.
Yeah, I'm gonna go to sleep with that thought. Good night.
Day 11, time to watch some videos on faces. Every head starts out with a circle.
Nice.
No, actually not nice. Circles are easily on my top 10 most hated list.
I actually genuinely hate circles.
I'm gonna just go with this circle.
He said for the circle to be symmetrical, but some faces are a little jacked up, so my circle is still correct.
Okay, I finally decided to use a reference for the hair, and there's so many choices, but I'm gonna aim for the one that won't give me carpal tunnel.
So I want this one, but let me stop. Her head's already jacked up. I can't make it any worse than this.
I'll go with this one.
And oh my gosh, am I ever gonna get the line I wanted?
All right, so this is looking pretty bad,
but spending any more time on this would not be beneficial, so I decided to leave it as is.
I went straight to painting with a 20-minute time limit.
I can't spend any more time on this. I won't do it.
All right, so I finished it, but
it's horrible.
Number one, it's really tiny,
so now if you zoom in, you can see the pixels.
Number two, the lines are thick,
and most importantly, the eyes are whatever that is.
Yeah, I'm not gonna claim this as a finished drawing.
It's just pixel art.
Yeah, that's what I was drawing, pixel art.
Oh, no, wait, even better.
I was making an NFT.
Selling for $1 billion. Who's buying?
You better not screenshot my work.
Look at that. You see that right there?
Copyrighted.
Don't you dare steal it.
But yeah, this is actually horrible.
Literally the definition of prettying up the turd.
But this was not a waste of time.
Now I know what I need to look more into.
Things like face structure, hair, and other technical things.
Like doing this made me realize I need to learn more about the face.
And I downloaded this 3D model that splits the face into thirds.
If you didn't know, the face is basically in thirds.
Like, look at the way these things line up.
But this tool is just a good way to check my work.
So I practiced structuring a few heads,
learned a little little bit about hair, and then I started looking for a face preference for practice. I found this classic picture of 02, but then I was like, the Reddit user that posted this was very darn bad. I'm afraid he's contagious. I did use it anyways, and I kept drawing faces with references, but I just wasn't getting. I was just sitting there, trying to figure out where I went wrong. Why does it look like this? And then I realized the answer was simple. Just practice, forehead. For the last 10 days, I've been making human bodies, not faces. So of course it's hard. I was like a baby trying to sprint, when all I knew how to do was sit there like a stupid baby. So as soon as I realized that, I got a huge mood boost. I put on some DaBaby and started grinding out construction of them heads. Not actually listening to DaBaby though, because that's torture. I gave myself 2 minutes for each head, and then I started breaking down some faces. Also, for some weird reason, I spent an hour on the ear. Don't ask me why, because I don't know why. But basically, I was breaking down 02's ears into easy to remember shapes. Ears aren't the coolest things and are one of those things that no one ever notices until you mess it up, so you gotta know them. But you know what else is glaring at me? The amount of days left. I did go from this to this, but I'm gonna need to step it up. Today, I decided to learn how to draw eyes. So I searched up a tutorial and tried drawing them. He started out with a diamond shape, so the viewer could draw the eye easier, and then we blended in the rest of the colors. At first glance, there aren't any glaring issues, and if I were to analyze and point out the differences, which I am, I noticed that my iris is a bit blocky when his is a nice oval, but I'd still say this eye was a success. I learned a lot here. Now it's gonna be learning how to paint hair, which is probably gonna be harder. First, I started out with the line art, and instead of watching a tutorial on hairstyle, I decided to pull up a reference of a character I drew in my last video. But wait, actually, that's not what the people wanted. You guys wanna see me suffer, don't you?
Don't you?
Well, time for me to draw a hairstyle I haven't tried before. But jeez, look at that circle. But yeah, that perfect circle doesn't matter when he butchered that stuff in the inside.
My god, why can't I just draw some Pixar, guys? Come on, guys, I know you love some Pixar.
Anyways, after an hour of watching tutorials and learning about how the hair does this, and how the hair connects to the center of the head, I was finally able to draw a sketch, and I mean, this draw looking pretty trash. Any more time on this would be counterproductive though. And yeah, after 30 minutes of drawing line art, I decided to go back and start all over again to the sketch, because look at where it was going. It was not gonna end well. Eventually, I looked for some more tutorials, which taught me that the hair can be split into three sections, bang, side, and back hair. This way, it makes it really easy for you to create an actual hairstyle. And this helped me realize the solution to all my problems. Make the hair longer to hide all the mistakes. You know how people just add eye patches to hide their horribly drawn second eye? Yeah, I was doing that. Yeah, I know. I'm a genius, guys.
Come on, you don't need to tell me. I already know.
All right, so I finished it. Sort of. This was just practice, so I was just testing the waters. Even though I may have accidentally jumped into the water, at least I know next time I draw hair, I'll be like 2 times quicker, since I've already noted all my mistakes and found the answers to them. Also, I added the eyes from earlier, but the eyes obviously are wrong, but I couldn't care less right now. It's 11 p.m. I'll try to fix them later. And after coloring this, I realized that she's looking pretty spicy, but no, not really. I was not aiming to make this, but again, it's progress. It was better than last time, and I learned a lot from it, so it's fine. Like I said, to make the bangs symmetrical, but they don't look like they're lining up. This is another case of putting up the turd.
Anyways, what's all this? Oh my god.
Well, I was scrolling on Pinterest or something. I was like, hey, heads, let's do it. I'd love to be able to do that. Well, it's not looking too good. And some of these look bad. I kept drawing these so I could get a better understanding of them, since faces are basically the focal point of almost every drawing. So then I started breaking down everything, how many lines they use for the jaw and for the cheeks as well. And I think this looks great. Like, if you're blind and you squint really closely, they look the same. All right, we're at the halfway point, but there's still so much I need to learn. I haven't gone over folds, hands, feet, but today I'm still gonna work on faces. You can hide the hands, you can hide the feet, but you cannot hide the face. Right now I'm gonna go for something a bit more finished, because I've drawn heads for like 8 hours in the last 2 days, and hopefully maybe it'd be good enough for the thumbnail. Who knows? Just a prediction, this is not gonna be the thumbnail though. All right, for this character, I'll be using these two as a reference. I'll be drawing pink hair, but I'll be using the shape of blue hair's face. Blue hair is from the anime that has probably one of the best animations, so who better to learn from than them? Also, if you're wondering why I'm drawing Sakura, it's simple. We love Sakura. All right, so I've been drawing and
I've accidentally carried her forehead over. Oh no. I went really crazy with her forehead. I didn't think it could get any longer.
Instantly, as soon as I shrunk the forehead, the picture was so much better. I'm actually pretty happy with this rough draft. So now it's time to do the final line art. Probably the hardest part, since I'm still not great at controlling my pen. But again, I've been learning a lot from my past mistakes. Remember, I was drawing the hair too thick. I wasn't coloring the hair correctly. The eyes were in the wrong places. All of those mistakes were helping me out here. And boom, here's here's the finished line art, and it's not looking too bad. So then I started painting, and I was like, dang, this is really easy.
But no, not really though.
It took 2 hours of watching tutorials and had to adjust the colors like 5 freaking times.
But I did learn some good stuff from the tutorials. I learned that you want to make the center of the hairpiece smoother and lighter for best looks. Also, I had a huge problem with shading the hair. For some reason, I tried shading the hair without imagining where the light was coming from. So I drew this tarantula looking sun thing to help me visualize where the light was coming from. And with a few more touch-ups, actually a lot more touch-ups, I had a finished Sakura painting, and I'm pretty happy with this. Look at the improvement from here to here. You can see that I learned so much from the other mistakes.
Look at the evolution, guys.
And I was gonna trash on my painting to find some mistakes, but the only thing that stands out is the eyebrows. Maybe once I learn more in the future, I'll be able to see more what's wrong with it. But to my newbie untrained eye, this was a success, but I still haven't practiced some of the hardest stuff yet.
Like hands. All my homies hate hands. That's why I won't be doing them till later.
Today, I wanted to see what mistakes I'd have when drawing a full human body. So I picked a pretty hard pose to practice on. She's sitting, got her legs bent, she's leaning back, and the picture is taken at an angle.
Almost as hard as it gets.
I drew the sketch, finished the line art, added some base colors, and this is the finished painting. And all I gotta say is, this is horrible. Which is fine, because I learned a lot from this though. That was the reason why I did this anyways. And I came to the conclusion that there's just a lot I don't know. It's just as simple as that. I couldn't figure out how to make it look like she was actually sitting. Her butt's flat. Her face is flat and ugly.
And her knees are pointy.
And worst of all, the picture is flat.
AKA not 3D.
So that means there's something I don't understand about perspective and shading.
Also, where the freak is this line going? It makes no sense. I don't know how that made the cut.
But this really told me I don't know perspective as well as I thought I did. So I'm gonna work on that tomorrow. Day 19, and I spent my time learning more about the human body and 3D shapes. I'm pretty baby brain when it comes to this stuff. For example, I never paid enough attention to the bones, which is a freaking crisis. Like, am I dumb? Am I stupid? It's not even that hard, and plus all the meat connects to them. There's only 13 bones to learn. Once I realized this, I started learning all the bones and muscles and even how to pronounce them so I can maybe memorize them better.
Brachioradialis.
All right, but seriously, who even came up with that word? Who decided to create a word that's over 15 characters long? That's illegal.
Okay, so it's day 20 now, but why is the arm so complicated? Like,
it says, when were there 14 muscles just on your forearm? Are you kidding me?
Yeah, I'm not gonna be memorizing the forearm because that's over the top. But actually, I will. It can be put together into two groups. All the other muscle shapes were easy to memorize as well.
It took a while, but I think I got it.
But you know, very recently, I've been having a very serious problem.
Very serious.
I've been x-raying my own legs.
Like, every time I looked at a body part, my brain would just automatically label the muscles.
Like, I wasn't even trying to do all that.
But since I've been studying it so much, my brain just automatically goes to that. It's like that feeling when you buy a new car and then you notice that everyone else has the same car too.
But this is what I was aiming for. Just think about it.
The reason why you recognize everyone else has the same car as you is because the way your car looks has been etched into your brain.
So without even thinking about it, you're gonna notice your car more often. Same with anatomy. I can now spot all the weird stuff going on in the human body.
But really though, the human body is strange. Like, if you just take your hand and turn it, only one of your forearm bones are moving.
I didn't even know there was two bones to begin with.
If you didn't understand that one, I got one that's just as weird.
So basically, instead of your legs bending like a flip phone, your thigh bone actually rolls over to calf bone.
That's some extraterrestrial stuff right there. I'm definitely gonna be bugging out tonight.
But it's still day, and I got a lot of stuff to work on.
Like the stupid pelvis.
Like, there ain't no way there's anything harder to draw than this.
So to make things simpler for my tiny ant brain, I spent time perfecting my understanding of 3D boxes and perspective so that I could put the pelvis in an easy to draw box.
And I kid you not, I legit spent the whole entire day drawing boxes.
With Donda on loop, I was just drawing boxes for what?
For like an eternity.
There was even a point where I tried to move the box like it was actually a 3D model, which is actually a good sign. That means that my stupid brain thought the box was drawn so well that it thought I could spin it around.
I already know my dream's gonna be wacky tonight.
If I'm not playing Minecraft with floating body parts around in my dream, then I'll be shocked.
But you know what? I've been drawing boxes for a few hours now,
but that's all it's taken to completely change my whole understanding of 3D.
It feels like my mind has been awakened.
I should have been doing this stuff since day one, because I'm probably progressing like 10 times faster now.
Not even trolling.
All right, it's day 21 and we got a lot of stuff to do.
Shading hair, drawing hair, creating curvy legs, creating curvy butts, hands, feet, folds.
I gotta get to work.
But to be honest, today I only did 3 things.
I just drew shapes, muscles, and bones.
For hours on end?
4 days in a row?
Drawing all this stuff may seem boring,
but for me, it was liberating.
All right, so after a bunch of days of grinding, I actually wanted to paint something.
I planned on combining these two images again, but wait,
this joint is horrible.
I haven't seen this in like a week, but I did not remember it being like this.
Whoever drew this needs to get their hands cut off.
Imagine I roast this and then the second one comes out even worse.
All right, I'm 1 hour in and I'm already stumped.
It's just a really hard pose.
I don't know how to make it look like she's actually sitting. I had to break her apart like a Lego so many times. But let's fast forward and see how I did.
Boom, here are the results, but to be honest, it's not that much better from the last.
So I'ma roast it so I could do better next time.
Boom, the shading is trash. The face is trash.
It doesn't even look like she's sitting. Doesn't even look like she's twisting.
And again, worst of all, it's flat, therefore not 3D.
And she got no ears.
All right, yeah, I kind of feel better now.
But to be honest, I think I learned a lot more from the mistakes this time. The ear and jaw were there in the sketch, but not in the final, so I'll make sure not to do that again. I also should have just followed along with the shading in the reference. It would have actually made her look like she's sitting. Last thing, the foot needs to be faced more towards the viewer, because the way it's positioned makes the whole image look 2D and not 3D.
By the way, I might have realized the foot mistake mid-drawing just might be the reason why I sense it flying. Just maybe.
But you guys know something?
There's literally no time left. What I'm imagining now is gonna be impossible.
Alright, it's day 26. Today, I spent most of my time drawing faces, because if the face ain't right, then the whole painting is immediately trash.
And I was in the lab, man. I was trying to get my faces perfect.
But my problem was making the cheeks cute and plumpy.
Or even look like a guy cheek.
So I worked on that for a while and then started on the eyes.
And good eyes look so good.
I also remember how the first eye I drew took 30 minutes when I spent like a quarter of the time on this. Last thing to show off are these two lips I drew. The second one I drew is surprisingly not that bad. But the first one is straight dog.
Day 27 and I instantly started working on the feet. And you like my feet, guys?
They're kind of cute if you lay your head to the right.
Yeah, no, I'm hard capping.
If you didn't know, this is the very reason why I've been avoiding hands and feet. They're insanely hard to draw.
Like, imagine this got into your house and then tries to wake you up at night.
I don't even know what I'd do at that point.
But hey, even though this last one's trash,
it's still less trash than the first one, so it's progress.
And all progress counts.
Even if it does look like I got stuck in an anthole.
Day 28.
I finally started working on the hands.
And oh my god, they are ugly.
Them joints got ran over.
But I predicted this.
Like, just sit there and just think about how many little bones are on your hand.
Like, what?
I did learn what you needed to do to make good hands, though.
Also, I've been thinking that I'm gonna need 2 days to make a final painting.
So this is the last practice exercise.
I ended the grinding phase with these hands.
What a horrible end to the grinding phase.
I barely got to work on folds, hair, and eyes in pairs.
And I still need some work on shading, but I'ma hope for the best and see what happens.
Alright, it's the final day.
We've come a long way.
Look at the stuff I started on drawing.
Look at Sasuke.
Look at her.
And alright, no more stalling. 3, 2, 1.
It's the Kermit special.
We got the legend Kermit beating the ribs out of Sasuke.
And then boom, we got Blondie over here stomping the guts out of baby Kermit like a beast.
And what's this?
He having a party in Zero Two's mouth.
What the freak he doing in there?
But well, damn.
Went from not being able to hold my pencil to drawing this in 30 days?
I'm happy with it.
And I'm so glad I don't have to watch any more tutorials mid-paint.
This is the beginning of the beginning.
Check out my Twitter to entertain yourself.
Link in description.
And with that, thanks for watching to the end and peace.
Have a good day.